The number 31, the quick qualifier, Greg Estes. Greg Estes blistered his track, got under the 15 seconds, got down to the 14 second time. And then we got Jamie Witt in the J1 right beside him. Jamie, a very strong competitor. In row two, it's going to be Chris Rickett, the number 36. Then the 31B of Willie Bussler. Row three, Dave Smith in the red, white, and blue, number 10. Right beside of Austin Atkins. In row four, Ronnie Roberts and Chris Phillips, or Clinus Phillips. And then in row five, Dale Reed, John Cook. Row six, Brett Banks, David Bullington. Row seven, Terry Dean and Landon Steele. And rounding them out, Jeff Ferguson in the number 24. It doesn't look like Jeff Ferguson is going to make the field. And let's go racing. We've got the green flag flying high in the air. Terry Gillenwater letting it fly. We appreciate Terry sitting in for Robbie tonight. Checkers recuperating from a motorcycle accident. As we get racing, looking for lap number one. Can we get it in without a caution? And yes, we do. Greg Estes scorches out to the lead. Several car lengths put some real estate between him and Jamie Witt. Witt into a distant second place. And right behind him, he's got the number 36 of Chris Rickett about three car lengths back as they come out of turn four. Back. Estes down the back straightaway. We're on lap number seven. Three to go in this first dash. And I want you to look down here on the concourse. Dwayne Hommel standing to take pictures of some of the fans. That is a sight to see. Oh, we got a spin out and a caution. It's going to bring it out on lap number eight. That's going to be the... single file. He'll lead them off of turn four. Cone is out, looking for the green flag from the flag stand, and there it goes. Greg Estes shoots out to the lead again, starting to put some real estate between him and Jamie Witt. Now here comes Rickett, looking on the inside of Witt. Nothing doing. Witt pulls away. Rickett settles in at third. All right, we've got one lap in. Rest of the field now coming off of turn four by the flag stand. Estes leads them down the back straightaway. Battle for fourth. Estes still way ahead in the lead as he's coming up on a lot of lap traffic. He's already made his way around Dean, and now he's got Dale Reed just ahead of him as he comes around and gets ready to lap several more cars. We're on lap number seven. Estes will take us into lap number eight as he comes off of turn four. The battle for fourth still brewing. And here we go as they come by the cone. Greg Estes leads them off of turn four. Estes shooting out to a quick lead. Jamie Witt trying to hold off the number 36 of Ricketts. Third place is Ricketts. Now he dips down on the inside of Witt. They're battling door to door off of turn four down the front straightaway. At least gained second place out of this race. The white flag flies for Estes as he brings them by on the final lap. Greg Estes is going to come around and he'll take the win. Now battle for second place. And it looks like Chris Ricketts is going to grab second away from Jamie Witt.
Started this thing off with a strong run tonight. I mean, you qualified under 15 seconds. You had a 14, I think it was a 14.5 qualifying time. I mean, you blistered the track in this class tonight.
Yeah, it's, I mean, I got to think, you know, it's all because of Bill Curl and Sue Curl. They keep the car, they baby it, take care of it. They've made a lot of changes on it. We wrecked it last October, and I said sell it. It's totaled. They fixed it back, and it's a little bit better than it was then. So I just got to thank them and Dick Hill Race Engines and all my sponsors from back in Lee County, Virginia.